Welcome to week three of Against the Spread. I'm Drew Livingstone. That's Cam Stewart. Last week, I beat Cam, edged him out by one, but I'm still three back in our season-long standings. Not looking good for me at the end of the month, Cam, when it comes to the punishment.
No, you're only a few games back, but the important thing, the three picks, 3-0, you go 1-2. Where's my bonus picks? And I want to see you eat something stupid. So
hey,
hit the grocery store.
Luckily, the best bets don't add any bonus for the punishment at the end of the month.
Okay.
But you got a three-game lead, so you're laughing right now.
I looked at this week, Drew, and nothing looks good to me. Like, I almost hate every single game right now what I'm looking at. And that's the problem. Like, week one, I really like things, and now I'm going to – I have a lot of question marks, but – we'll see what happens here. Anyway, we'll start things off, and I'm probably going to have every opposite pick to you, I have a feeling.
I mean, that might be good, or it could be very bad for me. So, yeah, we'll begin with the Thursday nighter. Prime time, amazing game on the slate, Cam. We got Davis Mills against Sam Darnold. Carolina laying 7.5 on the road, going to Houston. I have no idea what to do with this game. I like Carolina, but 7.5 is a lot of points to give a home dog.
I agree. I think this game's horrible, and this is the start of the horrible Thursday nighters. So we have to give opinions and leans on all the games. And I have a lean to Houston. Mills was 1-for-1, one touchdown, one interception, just threw over 100 yards in relief of Tyrod Taylor. It was a bad situation. Houston's actually covered the number both weeks, though, guys. They're 2-0 against the spread. I can't lay 7.5 with Carolina. Do I think Carolina's going to win the game? Yes. If you want to put them in some money line parlays, but asking them to win by 8 points at this stage is a lot. I have a lean to the Houston Texans.
I'm going to go the other way, Cam. I think Carolina also 2-0 against the spread. A very impressive victory against the Saints last week. Jameis Winston looked like a shell of what he was in week one. I'll go Panthers. I think the only scary part is Houston could backdoor cover with a garbage time touchdown. I think that's where you'd get it, but I'm going to go Carolina. So with us disagreeing, we have to go to Tommy Tiebreaker, who's now 12-4 on the season. Let's see who he sides with here.
Yeah, I'm going to lean Cammy to open things up here, fellas. I think it's a lot of points. Plus, a lot of Sam Darnold games in both of his jerseys, and he's not a good quarterback. All will be revealed. Wow. This is Houston. David Mills, like yeah, Cammy said, came in, looked decent in relief. So I think Brandon Cooks is going to be cooking all night. Give me the Texans.
All right. Well, not good for me.
Let's call it out for what it is. Yeah. That game reeks like old garbage in the sun. But you know what? We got to have an opinion on it. But this is tough. Like, you're not going to the bank and saying, I have full confidence in Carolina or Houston in this game. Like, it's a tough one.
No, the props I'll be betting are all the Carolina side, though. I'll give it that. Like, I'm not betting it over on any Houston player.
I get it.
All right, moving on. My Buffalo Bills, big win. Shout out of the Miami Dolphins hosting the Washington football team, laying 9 at home. That's a huge number, Cam. Where are you leaning?
I hate to say this. The Bills were one of our top bets, Drew. We both hit them hard last week. One of my favorites went very hard against Miami. I'm not laying 9 points with Buffalo in this game. I think the Bills win, but asking them to win by 10 is a lot. I'm going to have to go with Washington. Just keeping the trend with the dogs, it seems like a lot more public money is going to be on Buffalo. Listen, Miami also had Tua go down. Jacoby Brissett came in that game. There was just a lot of mistakes made by the Dolphins in that game. It's a lot to ask Buffalo to cover that number. They're going to get better every week, but this line, if it was 7, 9's just a little bit too much for me. I lean with the Washington football team. I don't love it, but I'm going to take Washington. Too many points.
I don't like betting against my team, but I agree with you. I think Washington has a better defense than Miami. I think Josh Allen still doesn't look like himself from last season. So asking them to win by 2 scores is a lot. I know it's at home, but until he gets that rust off of his arm, I can't lean 2 scores with Buffalo.
Exactly. Like, the thing about Buffalo is, I think Buffalo is one of those teams that kind of believe they're hype. They're not really at full strength right now. They're kind of running at a 7.5. Soon they'll be running at a 10, Drew, and you'll be really happy because they're going to start blowing, you know, absolutely murdering teams. The Dolphins game was an anomaly due to the injuries in that game and the way it played out. I just think Washington with a defense, it's a dangerous type of situation. I see the Bills winning the game, but not covering.
Exactly. And we saw the issues with the Bills O-line against the Pittsburgh front. So Washington with Chase Young, it's going to be tough for them to block him as well. All right, moving on. The Tennessee Titans, who upset your Seattle Seahawks. I remember I texted Cam live on Sunday. I said, the Titans are screwing me. They need to wake up. And you said, calm down, buddy. Right after that, they came flying back and won in overtime. That was insane.
Here's the thing about Seattle. I'm a fan of the team, but and people are texting me going, oh, I can't believe they blew a 15-point lead. Have you not watched this team play? Like, their defense is not great. The good thing is about Seattle is they can score with the best of them. And again, I don't know what is going on with Lockett. He's been on my bench in fantasy. If you got him, like this guy, him and Russell Wilson got something special going on here.
Why aren't you starting
him? But I started Calvin Ridley. Anyway, Drew, like, this is not a fantasy football show. This is a gambling show. We'll talk about that. But yes, you're right. You can scold me afterwards. What do we do with this game? Oh my God. Who's quarterback? By the time we tape this, we don't even know who's quarterbacking Indianapolis, right?
I mean, to me, it doesn't matter who's quarterback. I'm going Titans all the way. I think they absolutely blow Indy out of the building here. The Indianapolis Colts have not looked good. The receivers are hurt. Their quarterback's hurt. I just think the Titans woke up in the second half, and I think they carry that momentum into this game, and they cover the touchdown.
Oh, it's 5 points. We're betting it at 5 right now. It opened at 6, and people are actually...
So I think they win by a touchdown.
People are betting the Colts, which is kind of a good sign, I guess. Drew, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, just taking, like, public favorites is never a way to go, but I really can't make a case for Indianapolis either. The thing is, Carson Wentz is horrible to begin with. If Jacob Eason or Sam Ellinger, the kid from Texas, comes in, it doesn't really matter. I got to give Indy credit, though. They battled the Rams in that game, Drew. They covered the number. They lost by 3. That line was 3.5. But Tennessee, maybe they get right in Seattle and come back home. That first week against Arizona was just a bad game for them. All they got to do is win by 6. I think they'll win this game by 10 to 13 points. I agree. That's the one favor. We'll take the Tennessee Titans. Remember the Titans.
You saw Carson Wentz throw an interception on a shuttle pass. I don't think I've ever seen that. I was like, it's a one-yard shuttle. How are you throwing a pick on this play? It made no sense. I think I honestly don't think he's their quarterback next season. I don't think he lasts in the NFL after this year.
I agree with you. I think Carson Wentz's NFL days are few and far between. He won't go to the CFL. He's got too many injuries. It's going to be nice. I don't know if he's going to be working at insurance. I know ex-athletes get jobs at Enterprise Rent-A-Car. He's got enough money, though, from the deals that he's made with the Philadelphia Eagles. He can sleep on a stash of money. But it's hard to watch Carson Wentz. He's hurt all the time. And, Drew, as we talked about, you can't hold the ball for 3.5 seconds in today's NFL.
No, maybe Andy Luck will hook him up with an architecture job in Indianapolis. We'll see.
Maybe.
Moving on to probably your favorite game of the week. I know it's not mine. The Giants hosting the Falcons, laying 3 at home. What a mess this game is. I have no idea, Cam. You got to tell me what you think.
Well, how come I always have to start all the time? Okay, this game has got train wreck written all over it. I don't know what to do. I'll tell you one thing, though. The Atlanta Falcons were my pick last week, and you got a win for that game, and you were lucky to get a win for that game. At the end of the game, Matt Ryan threw 2 pick sixes there. They were actually hanging and only down a field goal to Tampa Bay. Here's the thing. The Giants don't have the same defense as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I love the Giants in the spot against when you're playing a team like Washington getting points. Now we're laying points with the G-men. This sounds crazy, Drew. Give me the beat-up, wounded Atlanta Falcon. He's got one wing. He's got a bullet in his eye. He's trying to fly, but I'm getting 3. Give me the Falcons. I think if the Giants win, it is by a field goal at the most, so I'll take the pooch, or in this case, the wounded bird.
I'm going to go the other way, Cam. I like the Giants in the spot. I thought they should have beat Washington last week. They got screwed at the end there. Kenny Golladay yelling at the coach. I think that's good. I know people say they don't like that, but I think Saquon wakes up. Kenny Golladay wakes up. And I think going against Atlanta now, their defense is bad. So I think this is the week we finally see Saquon unleashed, which means we need to go to Tommy tiebreaker again. Tom, whose side are you leaning?
Yeah, I'm going to lean Drew for this one. The Giants almost scored 30 points against Washington. And that last point you made, I think, is the only point that matters. This is a terrible defense in Atlanta. The G-men can low-key score some points. They got a few playmakers on their team. I don't want to pick them, but yeah, give me the Giants.
Yeah, like we said before, these aren't games we're rushing to the window to bet. I don't know, maybe Cam is, but I will not be rushing to bet the Giants or Falcons this weekend.
I might, hey. I liked loser game last week. Like Bears-Bengals was my loser game, but we got it done, right? So I really don't care what games you bet. If you win your bets, that's good. And I'm just saying today's board, though, this is a week that it looks like people are going to get absolutely crushed because these things look easy, like good teams against teams that have been disappointing. The NFL's never easy. Like when it looks too easy, it's not. So I got to be awesome. You got to beware, caution. Like there's got to be police tape up on some of these games because they look very scary to me. Nothing is obvious and easy, Drew. It might look that way, but it isn't.
You know what game looks obvious and easy is this next one, but I think it's got trap written all over it. It's Lions hosting the Ravens. Ravens laying 8.5 on the road. Detroit did not look bad at the start of this game against Green Bay last night, Cam.
Yep.
I think I got to lean Lions. 8.5.
I love it, Drew. You're seeing that's my dirty influence on you. Like
I know it is. It is.
The old Drew would be like, Baltimore's going to kill these guys. But I'll tell you, like, you know what? There's going to be trap games, and I think you might have sniffed this one out too. I'm taking Detroit. Detroit dominated Green Bay. They shredded that defense in the first half. Swift, they should have got Hawkinson. They got weapons. Baltimore feeling good about themselves after beating KC. Letdown spot. They got to go in Detroit. You're going to give me the Lions as an 8-point home dog. I think the Lions are going to battle in this game, and they will not quit. Goff in the second half was horrible. The fumbles.
Horrible.
Slippery fingers. No, he cost Detroit. Detroit should have covered in that game against Green Bay, Drew. That's all on Goff in the second half. He was masterful in the first, horrible in the second. As for Baltimore, everyone's going to run, oh, these guys beat Kansas City. You think they're going to beat Detroit by more than 9 points? We're getting 8 points here. I'm taking the Detroit Lions. Lions, show me some damn teeth. You got to play 60 minutes of football and you'll get the cover.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I think they get the backdoor cover, or at least I think they could be leading in this game for a lot of it. The issue is Lamar and his rushing ability. Can the Lions contain it? They couldn't contain Aaron Jones, but it was Aaron Jones in the air. It was not on the ground that gave him problems. So, yeah, this has trap game for the Ravens written all over it. I don't even think it's probably going to be the most popular Survivor pick, but I wouldn't be taking this game in Survivor.
I agree with you. I think Detroit might win outright. I'll take the damn points.
It's possible. Okay. All right, Arizona going to Jacksonville, laying 7.5 on the road. Another huge road favorite, but I'm going with Arizona on this side after they escaped against Minnesota. They should have lost that game. The 37-yarder Minnesota missed. Embarrassing. What's with the Vikings missing last-second field goals in important games, Cam?
Yeah, it's true. Remember against Seattle in the Ice Bowl there, Drew? Yeah. And then with Walsh, the kick, and then Seattle picked them up. No, it's just, you said it, Minnesota, like, I don't know what it is about their kicking. Yeah, and playoffs, even in the past, Drew, when you were a younger fan, remember back in the day when they were playing, was it, who was their kicker? Was it for Detroit back then? He missed a huge kick against Atlanta. Like, you're right. Every time there's a big game, a playoff game, or a game to win, Minnesota's got no kicking. I'm going to do something crazy here, Drew. Give me the Jaguar. It looks like I'm going to be a fan of cats this week. I got the Lions and I got the Jaguars. I could be the only person taking them. I think that hook is huge. I think probably 90% of the public will be on Arizona. This is the thing. I'm not saying Jacksonville's a good team, but I think Arizona's playing with fire. This is the type of game they go in. They win by a touchdown and lose by the hook. I like Arizona. This hook is very important to me.
One worry I have is Jacksonville has had one red zone trip in 2 weeks. One. That's very, very bad. How do you have – you can't get inside the 20-yard line, Cam, and you're going to try and keep up with Kyler Murray and the Cardinals offense? I just don't see how they do it. Urban Meyer can't –
Why isn't the spread NFL. 12 then?
It's 7.5 right now, Arizona laying 7.5 on the road. So
I hate the game, Drew, but part of the show is we pick every game, right? And I'm not going to take Arizona. I'm taking Jacksonville because I'm a little bit off. Do I need to see a doctor? Perhaps. But you know what? I'm going to take Jacksonville. I just think enough. Home dog, these guys, I get it. Hey, they lost that by Denver Broncos are a good team. They lost by 10 points. It's not like they're getting absolutely throttled too. I think this game is kind of a sneaky game. Arizona comes here cocky. They should have lost that game to Minnesota. I'm taking Jacksonville, holding my breath because it's this is the old plug your nose, it stinks game, but I'm taking the Jaguars.
All right, Tommy Tiebreaker, who are you going with?
Yeah, I mean, I would take this game for Arizona if it was minus 13, minus 14. I think I'm riding Arizona hard all year. They're electric, man. And on both sides of the ball, Chandler Jones is going to feast off Trevor Lawrence on that Jacksonville Jaguars O-line. So I think that this spread could keep growing and still be on Arizona, 100%.
Well, yeah, it opened at 7, and now it's 7.5. So it's definitely going to – I think it closes around 8 or 9, if I had to guess, by Sunday. The one worry, like Cam knows, is 80% of the public's on Arizona, and that's usually not a good sign for the favorite.
That's why I'm betting Jacksonville. I'm not saying Jacksonville's a good team. I'm not saying Trevor Lawrence. He's been horrible in the first 2 weeks. I'm just saying Arizona has had an escape act. They played great the first week. They got lucky against Minnesota. This could be overconfidence game where they come out business trip. They barely beat Jacksonville and find a way to win. But I'm not betting them to cover the number.
All right, moving on to this next game, which I have a really tough time with. This one, you're going first on this one. We got Chargers going to KC. KC laying 6.5 at home. I feel like everyone's going to be on the Chargers, but then I look at it and 60% of the public's on the Chiefs. So this doesn't make any sense to me. Who are you leaning?
This game's giving me a headache, Drew. We haven't even talked about it for more than a second here. I'm going to take the Lightning Bolts. Here's the thing about the Kansas City Chiefs. Have you looked at their record ATS recently? It is horrible. Everyone thinks, oh, KC. They don't cover numbers anymore. This is the problem with this team. It's a divisional game. Kansas City should win. The fact that they lost to Baltimore, that's what's scaring me.
Yeah.
It's not going to be one of my top plays. I'm going to take the Chargers, hold my breath. Herbert and them, they're unbelievable too. They shoot themselves in the foot in that Dallas game. It's just, man, it's asking KC a lot, though, to win by a touchdown. I have a lean to the Chargers, Drew.
I don't know. I'm so stuck on this game because the Chiefs should win this game, but
are they going to win by 7? That's the question.
Exactly. That's the issue. And because it's such a big number, I mean, if it was 7, I feel like I would go Chargers. 6.5, I feel like KC can win by 7. Give me the Chiefs. I know I'm going to regret this pick, but I'm going to go Chiefs against you. Tommy, who you got?
Yeah, I agree with Cammy. The number's too big. Chargers score points. KC's defense looked a little leaky at times. So, yeah, give me the Chargers.
I mean, they should have won last week, and they had a big letdown against Dallas. So, I don't know.
That's the thing about the Chargers. You never know what you're going to get from them. KC's become a bad favorite. Like, this game is horrible, right? So, I'm actually surprised 62% of the betting public's on KC by the time we tape the show, Drew.
And the line's going the other way.
50. Yeah, it's reverse line movement. That's always a kind of an interesting scenario. That makes me want to take the Chargers, and I will.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like the books are like, no, look, take the Chiefs. Take the Chiefs. We took the half point off. Take the Chiefs. So they want the bets to come in on KC, and they are, which is a bad sign for me, but we'll see how it plays out. Chicago going to Cleveland. Your Brownies laying 7 at home. Andy Dalton looks like he's probably not playing, but we don't know for sure. And then we don't know if it's going to be Nick Foles starting, if Dalton doesn't play, or if it's going to be Fields. Personally, if they go to Nick Foles, that's just a coward's play by Nagy. Just give Fields the reins already.
Drew, I'm going to tell you something, and you're not going to like it. Andy Dalton played better than Justin Fields. Trust me, because I had a huge, that was
sure.
one of my biggest
bets.
But
if he can't play, would you go Foles or Fields?
No, you go Fields. And you let him learn like the other rookie quarterbacks. My point being, though, if Dalton isn't playing, I don't think this is a real advantage to the Bears. Justin Fields is going to be a good quarterback. He is simply not ready yet. It's just, I watched the guy play. They almost blew that game. They had a huge lead. And him down the stretch, they got lucky, man. One more drive, or one more. If Cincinnati had any more timeouts, I was sweating that game so hard, Drew. They should have been an easy cover. It wasn't. We ended up winning by the hook as the Bears collapsed. I'm going to tell you this. I don't like it, but I'm taking Cleveland. And I like Chicago. They won for me big last week. I think Cleveland, though, murders these guys. This is Chicago's defense on the road now, not at home. Cleveland, they haven't been playing their best football. You're asking me for these guys to cover a touchdown. I think they can. I think the Browns win this game by 13 points. Give me Cleveland.
I'm going to agree with you. I'm siding with Cleveland. My only worry is Landry's out. Odell, is he playing? Is he not playing? We don't know. So Donovan Peoples-Jones is probably the number one receiver on Sunday, which gives me a little worry. But at the same time, Cleveland's defense better than Cincinnati's. Cleveland's run game better than Cincinnati's. Cleveland's quarterback maybe better than Cincinnati's. I don't know. But I think, especially if Dalton's not playing, I think Cleveland easily covers this number. If Dalton does play, it'll be closer. But I still give me Cleveland by 7.
Love it.
All right. New England hosting the Saints, laying 3 at home. Huge win against the Jets. Zach Wilson looked absolutely terrible against the Bill Belichick-led defense. Jameis Winston also looked very bad. You want me to go first on this one, Cam? I'm going New England against Jameis Winston. Where are you leaning?
I'm leaning Saints. This is what I've learned about the Saints. Look great one week, horrible the next. I'll come back to them. Everyone thinks Winston, these guys are going to stink. This is where they show up. We're getting 3 points at New England. I think Peyton and the Saints will find a way to get it done. As for New England, wow, was that a really good win against the Jets? Not really. I know it's a divisional game, but, you know, the Jets rookie quarterback Wilson's been a train wreck. He's been absolutely brutal. So I'm going to take a shot with the Saints getting 3 in this spot.
I just don't know if I can trust Winston against the Belichick-led defense. And Mac Jones hasn't looked great either, but I don't know. You're giving me the better team, I feel like, and it's only 3 points. I'll go there. Tom, where are you going?
For the third straight week, I'm going to take New England. I don't want to pontificate or extrapolate on that, but I'll just take New England. I don't want to give any reasons because I don't want to say anything nice about them. I hate them so much. They're the bane of my existence. So, but for the third straight week, I'm going to pick them.
Fair enough. I mean, watch this where the Saints come in, like Cam said, and blow them out. But we'll have
to. I pray for it.
All right. Cincinnati going to Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh laying 4 at home. Bengals with a big letdown game against Chicago. Almost came back. Pittsburgh with a huge letdown against the Raiders. Big Ben not happy with Matt Canada as OC and the plays he's calling. He just straight up called him out after the game. Deontay Johnson's knees banged up. Their O-line doesn't look good. But I'm still going Pittsburgh, Cam. Where are you going?
I'm going Bengals. I don't like, as I said, I don't like many games this week. And this is another one that fits the bill. I want to take Pittsburgh. That 4 is too big. I don't really think Cincinnati's been good. Joe Burrow, everyone wants to anoint this guy the king. He wasn't that great against the Bears anyway. They had a pick 6 in that game. But Big Ben's hurt. There's something wrong with Pittsburgh. And the one thing is, if the Bengals can find a way to get pressure on them, this is going to be a long afternoon. Maybe Pittsburgh squeezes out a win between 1 and 3. They have to win by more than 4. That's good enough for me. I will take the Cincinnati Bengals in this spot. And another game, Drew. I'm hating this card more than I hate Tom's New England. Tom hates New England too. I do. I hate this card. I hate it.
You love the underdog Cats this week. That's the theme. The bear likes the Cats.
Yeah. What do I got? Yeah, I got Bengals. I got Jaguars. I got Lions. Holy God.
Yeah.
when you tell people that those are the teams I'm betting, it's usually a one-way ticket to the poorhouse. We'll see.
Yeah, I mean, we're very different so far this week, but I just think Steelers bounce back. I can't see a Mike Tomlin team going 1-2 after 3 weeks after going, 11-0 to start the year last year.
Yeah.
Give me the better coach at home. It's only 4 points, so that's a single touchdown. I think they can beat Cincinnati with their defense. So now we got to go back to Tommy Tiebreaker. Who you got?
Yeah, I'm with Cammy here. Give me the Bengals. Points, too many points. Pittsburgh doesn't know how to score. They've looked pretty inept offensively this year. And the Bengals have had some bright spots. T. Higgins looks good. Jamar Chase looks good. I know Burrow hasn't impressed Cammy that much, but I mean, he's done enough. Division game's always close. I don't like the 4. It's probably going to be a field goal or less. So yeah, give me the Bengals.
All right, Tom siding with Cam again.
He sides with you a lot. Anyway, you start the next one. Jets and Denver. Denver minus 10.5.
Jets going to Denver. Mile High. Denver laying 10.5. This is a tough game, but I got to go Denver because Denver's defense is very good. Probably better than the Patriots. And we saw the Patriots smash Zach Wilson and the Jets. I don't think they've figured out their offense yet. New coach. I'll take the home team. It's a lot of points, but I think they could even shut them out. So I'll go Denver.
I take the Jets.
Oh man.
I don't want to. It's just too many points. Reverse line. Okay. So Denver's minus 11.5. Now it's 10.5 and the public money's on Denver. Like, what the hell is going on here? These guys are trying to throw me for a loop. Oh God, I don't want to take the Jets. The thing is, Denver, if the Jets score like 16 points, they'll cover in this game.
How many points? And they score 16?
And they score 13. If they score 13, they'll cover probably in this game. I'm not sure if Denver, I think Denver probably wins by 10 and the line's 10.5. I say, I don't like this card, Drew. I'm going with the Jets. And I have no empirical data. Zach Wilson has looked like an absolute train wreck. He's been horrible. The Jets suck. They're horrible against New England. I just think Denver's feeling good about themselves, and this is kind of a letdown spot.
I just think Denver's 2-0 against the spread. It's in Mile High. Their defense is one of the best in the league. Zach Wilson had trouble against the Patriots defense. I can't see him putting up more than 10 points in this game, honestly. So you're telling me I just need Denver to score 21, which I think they can against the Jets. So, all right, Tom, who you got?
Yeah, I think the only thing worse for a guy who just threw 4 picks against New England in New England is to go to, or I guess I was at home, but throws 4 picks against Bill Belichick New England, then has to travel to Mile High, play the Broncos in that defense. And it is a lot of points, but I know this seems, this looks like the Dolphins Bills. This could be a shutout for Denver here. And can they score 10 points? Yeah, of course. They got a lot of good pieces on offense too. So,
can I change my pick?
I don't like the 10.5 points, but I'm taking the Broncos.
Yeah. If you want to change your pick,
no, I know. Give me the damn Jets, and I hate doing it. It's just going to be different. I'm not betting this game. If I do it, I'd put Denver in a teaser or something. I don't know. I just asking Denver to win by 11 points is a lot, but their defense is damn good.
And Teddy Two Gloves looks very good so far.
I agree. I agree with that.
All right, one of my favorite picks of the week, Raiders hosting the Dolphins, laying 4.
You start.
Sore ribs. Don't know if he's going to play. He should play. If it's just a pain tolerance thing, I feel like he's going to play. Raiders off to a huge start, 2-0 against spread, 2-0 record. Gruden's feeling himself. Carr is a little banged up, but he should play. It could be a letdown spot, but give me the Raiders laying 4. Cam, going underdog again, aren't you?
Yeah, I am. Give me the Dolphins. Honestly, people think I just do this to be different. Like, no, I just, the thing about the Raiders is they're the type of team, you beat Baltimore, great game in Pittsburgh. This is like a classic letdown spot for the Raiders in this game. And it's 3.5. I think it's going to be a really tight game. I'm going to take the Miami Dolphins. Drew, this week, I actually might get murdered. This is the thing. We're taping a little bit earlier. Sometimes I change my picks, but we have to have an opinion. I just think it's too many damn points. The fact that the public is all over the Raiders, too, thinking they're just going to roll these guys, I'm not sure it's that simple. I'm going to take Miami.
I just think Miami's not a good offensive football team, Cam. It's, you're telling me they got to keep up with the Raiders, who look like they have a very potent offense. I know Miami's defense is good, but it didn't look good last week. Yeah, this is a very tough game, but it's one of my favorite picks. I think the Raiders absolutely blow them out. Tommy, tiebreaker, yet again, four straight games we've disagreed on. Tom, who you got?
There's dysfunction in Miami, and no one's talking about it. They were talking about bringing Deshaun Watson in this offseason. They don't even believe in Tua. We've seen what Tua's looked like. He's been embarrassing. Xavien Howard, week two after a bad loss to Buffalo, says it was like a funeral in the locker room. You got 15 weeks left of football. They're already throwing in the towel. Now they got to go play John Gruden, get his team up for any game. Preseason games they're fired up for. And the Raiders look really good, 2-0 against the spread too. I think that's an easy pick. I think 3.5 again. You could double that, put it around 6.5, 7. I'd still take it. Give me the Raiders.
As Gruden says, knock on wood if you're with me. And me and Tom are both knocking on wood, Cam. You don't want to change this pick, huh?
No, I don't. What am I knocking on? Yeah. The opposite of wood. I've...
All right, this one though,
I'm just looking at these games. Like, how hard is this? Like, I don't know what it is. I just hate the matchups, man.
You like the underdog in every game so far. I feel like, I mean, this next game though, I know you're going favorite because I am too. Seattle going to Minnesota, laying 2 on the road. I just said I'm going Seattle. Who are you going with?
I'm going with Seattle, but I don't really like it. I mean, Minnesota's going to win. Drew, if they lose, they go to 0-3. Like, if I wasn't a Seattle fan, I'd probably take Minnesota in this
spot. Get a kicker then, Minnesota. I'm sorry. You're going to 0-3. It's just factual.
Minnesota's going to win this game, Drew. I hate to say it.
All right. So you're going to the other side.
You
can't bet against your Seattle Seahawks 2 weeks in a row, though it did work last week.
So. I told you I loved Tennessee last week. How did that work out? Like, the thing is, I know this team. Like, Minnesota gave Arizona all they could handle in that game. Did they not?
Yes, but Arizona's defense isn't as good.
You're right. Seattle's going to tighten up. That was a horrible, heartbreaking loss. They got to go into Minnesota and get it right. They're going to win this game by like a field goal. It's very difficult. Give me Seattle. And if Minnesota wins, Drew, you can expect a text from me on Sunday at 8 p.m. Eastern telling you you're a turkey. Cam, and I'm going to say, don't ever make me change my picks again.
It might be my gold pick. I'll be honest right now.
Think Seattle over Minnesota is the best pick on the board?
Cam, I think Seattle absolutely destroys them.
Really?
I think it's Russell Wilson's coming out party.
I hope so, but Seattle beating Minnesota, a winless team desperate at home getting points. I don't know if it could be the best game of the week, but
I don't know. Hey, you're on my side now, so
I am on yours. No, Seattle's going to win that game.
Tampa going to LA. You can go first on this one. The Rams getting a point at home. This is potential NFC Championship preview, Cam. Where are you leaning? Both teams 2-0 against the
Rams. This is it. Everybody, you talk about the Buccaneers. Did you watch that game against Atlanta? Was Tampa Bay really? Let's actually do what while everyone greases Tom. Hey, Tom Brady, you're the best quarterback of all time. I get it. You're Benjamin Button born as a football player. You're getting better as you're older and when you're younger. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. The older he gets, the better. But let's look at what's happened this year. They should have lost to Dallas if Dallas wasn't an inept. Atlanta could have actually beat them as one of the worst teams in the league. But two pick sixes by Matt Ryan. Give me the damn Rams at home against the juggernaut Tampa Bay. I'm going to make this one of my top picks of the week. It's at least going to get bronze medal. I know it's crazy betting against Tampa Bay. I'm doing it. Give me the
Rams. I don't think it's that crazy. I was one of the crazy people that didn't think Tampa was even going to make the playoffs last season. I shouldn't admit that publicly, but that's what I thought. I think they had a huge letdown last week. Atlanta could have possibly won that game. That was a huge comeback that they did. Matt Ryan just let them down. I think the Rams are a lot better than the Falcons and Cowboys. So I'll take the Rams as well as the underdog at home. You're giving me them as Rams as the underdogs, which is probably one of the best teams in football. I can't say no to that, despite 65% of the public being on the Buccaneers and Tom Brady being everyone's favorite for MVP now. So let's settle down, Cam.
I agree, Drew. No, Tom Brady's great. And what he has done as an older guy is absolutely commendable. I think he's the best, but I'm just looking at the full body of work from Tampa Bay. This could be an 0-2 football team heading to this game. Instead, they're 2-0. They're playing with fire and playing with fire against a Rams team that's going to be jacked up for their Super Bowl, it feels like. Let's just say this. The Rams are, I think they really, really want to make a statement in this game and beat Tampa Bay and say, hey, we can play with you guys. So I'm going to take the Rams.
And like, they're going to be up for this game. You know they will be. So yeah, give me Sean McVay and approve a game. This next pick, Cam, I love it. Green Bay going to San Fran laying 3.5 at home. I don't like that the public's with me, but you're giving me Aaron Rodgers with 4 points to play with. I'll take the Packers.
I won't. I still think the Packers defense has a lot of problems there. Publicly bet underdogs, usually it's a very, very bad scene to be on. They usually go to die. Your tickets go to burn. San Francisco, I know it seems like a lot, 3.5. I'm still not impressed with what I saw with Green Bay. The second half was better. That was mostly to do with Jared Goff's mistakes. Green Bay, I love what Aaron Jones is up to. I still think it'll be a game. I think San Francisco wins between 4 and 6 points. The spread is 3.5. I will take the Niners. I don't love the game at all, but that's one favorite. I think everyone's going to jump back on Green Bay. When people jump on, I jump off. Give me San Francisco.
I think people saw San Fran dominate Philly last week, and they're just like, oh, yeah, now we got to go with San Fran. We're big favorites. They're 3.5 at home. I just don't buy it. I think Philly blew that game with their terrible play calling. Like, they could have been in that game. They could have won that game. I couldn't believe that Philly special on fourth down where the receiver had no one to throw to. What was that play call? So yeah, you're giving me Aaron Rodgers against San Fran. And he's in like prove it mode to me right now. Like, I saw him do some interviews and he's in like, you guys think I don't care? Watch this. So
if you saw Aaron Rodgers with a helmet on, you think he would be a squeegee kid and homeless there the way he looks right now. And yeah. Actually, it's funny on our show. He looks exactly like CM Punk, the wrestler. It's like, is he trying to look older, more beat down, and a guy that's like, you know, coming off a bender? It's unbelievable, Drew. Like, I look at Rodgers, I'm like, God, this guy's aged. Like, I know I got the gray in my beard, but I'm an older man. This guy, the last couple of years, has put like a decade on his life.
But you know what hasn't aged? That arm. You saw that throw to Robert Tonyan. That was yes. Unbelievable.
He's so, got a golden arm. I get it.
So yeah, you're giving me Packers. Packer you're giving me Packers as underdogs. I'll take it every time. Tommy, who you got?
I don't. I
told you, Tom. Stop.
Yeah, okay. I honestly have no idea. I think I'm gonna lean with Drew here, just because I think Aaron Rodgers is the difference maker in this game. I have to skew to the better quarterback because I think it's a bit of a coin toss for me.
Fair enough.
I don't like it, but I'll take the Packers.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a tough game. Tough game.
It's a very tough game. We got a tough board this week. Me and Cam have disagreed on like 8 or 9 games so far.
Yeah,
so
this is going to be the turning week. We'll see what happens.
Bad news for whoever's on the wrong side of this. Or we're both going to be 8-8 and it's going to be nothing happened. Last game of the week. Philly going to Dallas. Dallas laying 4 at home. NFC least showdown. Dallas, huge win against the Chargers last week. Philly, huge letdown against San Fran. Do they bounce back? Cam, where are you going? The public's pretty 50-50 on this one as well.
Yeah, it's a tough game. I think Dallas might squeeze out a win, but asking them to win by more than 4, and that's the number that we have now, could be a little ambitious. 3, it's surprising. I like the Dallas Cowboys. I like the way they played in both weeks. They've been actually, they could have beat Tampa Bay. They get the job done against a very good Charger team. Prescott, he wasn't fantastic, but Pollard's a guy that steps up. Dallas has been good, but here's the thing. Philadelphia have been a surprise to me. That winning against Atlanta the way they did and watching Atlanta battle with Tampa Bay actually gave me a little bit more respect for the Eagles. And I think I'm going to take the points with these guys right now. I think Jalen Hurts is improving as a quarterback week to week. He's starting to really figure it out. It's a divisional game. Dallas has to win by more than 4 to cover. Sorry, I'm going to take the Eagles here. Birds.
I'm going the other way, Cam. We're disagreeing on everything. I think Dallas has what it takes to blow the Eagles out. I think San Fran did it last week. And until Sirianni proves that he can call a proper playbook and not these trick plays to nobody and bad, poorly designed offense, give me the Cowboys with Prescott, Cooper, and C.D. Lamb. I think the Eagles are going to have a hard time slowing this team down. So, yeah, Tommy tiebreaker yet again. Who you got?
Yeah, again, I don't like this one either, boys. But I'm going to go Cowboys, better football team. Potent offense. Mark Cooper only had 24 yards last week. They still put up enough to win against, like you said, a good Chargers team. So, talk myself out of this, but I'll lock in the Cowboys. I'll lock in the Cowboys.
Okay, I'm looking at it right now. Me and Cam disagreed on 9 games, so it's going to be a very interesting week. I can't wait to see the results. Cam, we'll move on now to our Survivor picks. Who do you have on your docket this week? We're both survived through 2 weeks.
Yeah, we have. Who have I taken the first couple weeks? I took
Panthers week 1, and then we both went Browns last week.
Yeah, I think let's not screw around here. We're going to take Denver. I think Denver is going to be the play, even though I think the Jets can cover 10.5. I think we're going to go with Denver, home team. That's something I like to do. Everyone else is going to take Baltimore. I think that's dangerous against Detroit, so give me Denver.
I'm going to go, oddly enough, Thursday night, give me Carolina on the road against Houston. I think Carolina blows Houston out of the water. That's why I took them there. So give me the Panthers. The road cats is the one cat that you're not on this week.
Yeah, I kind of lack. I think they win the game. I should. You know what? That's a sign. I probably should bet the Panthers against Houston. Whatever. We'll let it go, Drew. So what do you want, gold, silver, bronze, buddy?
Yeah, so let's go with our third best picks of the week, our bronze picks. You give me yours first.
I'm going to go with bronze. And these are the thing. Like, these are probably the games that I'm betting. A lot of these other things are leans, guys. It's hard, man. Like, hey, for Drew, sure. Could I tell the people, like, we're doing the show a little bit early. Like, we're giving initial leans. But in the NFL, it's very, very difficult to lock and load. But a couple games I will. I think getting Washington at 9 as my bronze pick. And, Drew, we like Buffalo, too. I cheer for the Bills. You and my boy Morenci, all the people I know, like, a lot of Bills fans, friends of the family. But I just think it's too many points against Washington. I got to take the points with the smooth either Heinicke muffler or a nice smooth Heinicken. Heinicke and Washington getting 9. Too many points for the Bills to cover. Bronze.
Yeah, I like that pick, but it's not one of my top three. I'm going to go Raiders as my bronze pick. I think they easily cover the 4 against the Dolphins. That's just an easy bet for me to make, so I'll lock that in. My silver pick will be the Packers getting 3.5 points on the road against San Fran. Another thing that you're on the other side of, so I could have some really bad best bets this week, but give me the Packers. Who's your silver?
My silver, I'm going to go with Detroit. We're going to get another 8-point underdog against Baltimore. Hopefully this is a letdown spot for Baltimore. Goff, all you got to do is manage the game. Dump offs to Swift, find Hawkinson, and get a little bit more creative. I worry about the defense, though. That's the only problem. This wouldn't be a gold pick. Lamar Jackson should be able to score probably lots of points in this game, because I think Detroit has proven that they could score. They just give up a lot of points, too. But 8 points as a home dog is good enough for me. Lions.
All right, and then gold picks, our best bets of the week. I'm going to go Seattle, like I said. I think they smoke Minnesota. It's my favorite pick. I'll be going to the window making this part of every parlay, especially if I can tease it through 0 to 5 on the other side. I know they say don't tease through 0, but if the Vikings win, I think it's a close one, so I think that's a safe tease. Give me Seattle. Who you got?
Here's the deal. I'm going to go with the LA Rams. If we're going to be bold, we're going to be bold. It's going to be my gold pick. I think Tampa Bay has been playing with fire the first couple weeks. Like, this 2-0 record is not indicative of actually how bad their defense has been. Atlanta was carving these guys up, and Dallas carved them up. I think the Rams with Stafford will do enough. The line opened Rams as 2-point favorites. Now we're getting them as a 1-point dog. They win the game outright. Give me the Rams against the Tampa Bay Bucks, Super Bowl champs. I like the Rams in this spot.
I like the Rams as well. I think it'll be one of my favorite picks. Not my top three, but I'll definitely be betting it. Besides that, Cam, I think we'll have a successful week. Well, one of us will, because we're different on 9 games, and hopefully Tommy Tiebreaker continues his hot streak.
Hey, he's hot.
Besides that, any games you're absolutely staying away from? Like a game that the worst game of the week that you advise people not to bet on, what is it?
Games that I'm staying away from probably include Carolina, Houston, Indianapolis, Tennessee, Atlanta, New York Giants. What else do we got? Arizona, Jacksonville reeks. Chargers and KC. Ooh, that's trouble. What else do we got there? Hey, Jets and Denver, I'm scared. Miami and the Raiders, I smell trap. Drew, I'm telling you, there's literally like 4 or 5 games that I like. The rest of them is very, very difficult to me. I have to have a meeting with myself and get my stuff together. We've had a good record, though, with the gold. Are we 6-0 with the gold picks after 2 weeks?
4-0, yeah.
Yeah, no, I mean with the combined gold, silver, bronze. Like, we've had 2 weeks.
You're 6-0. I'm not 6-0.
Oh, geez. That's,
but you should be making lots of money, Cam. That's what
I'm doing. Okay. I'm not going to lie to you. I've had a really, like, last week was awesome, Drew, but I'm going to tell you, I have very little confidence this week. Last week, I liked the board. I don't like this board as much.
This smells like one of those weeks where the pool's winner gets like $800,000.
Yes, yes. This smells like it. Like, I could see the pool's winner, like a couple 8-point dogs, like winning outright and stuff like that. Yeah, you're right, Drew. It's going to be one of those ones that the consortiums are going to be hard to box. Somebody's going to win a lot of cake.
I'll get my wife to make a ticket just based off of jersey colors or something. I'll just
like my teacher in high school did. Where would I rather travel? And she won like $13,000. I go, that's a good method. Good for you.
Okay. Well, let us know what you thought of our picks down below. The race is tightening up. Cam has a 3-point lead on me in terms of who's going to eat the nasty food at the end of the month. Hopefully I can make up some ground. With us being so different, it looks bad for one of us. So we'll see you all next week, and I'll let you know on the results. Thanks for joining us.